हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू पूजाज रेसिपीज़। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू शो यू अ वेरी वेरी नाइस रेसिपी ऑफ ब्रिंजल एंड इट इज़ रियली एक्साइटिंग एंड वेरी न्यू रेसिपी। इट्स लाइक द भरवा बैंगन, होल स्टफ्ड बैंगन। सी दिस होल बैंगन आई हैव कट इनटू टू पीसेस, दिस वाज अ होल बैंगन। आई हैव टू, सो आई हैव कट इनटू फोर पीसेस एंड आई हैव पुट दिस क्रिस क्रॉसेस एंड पुट लिटिल बिट ऑफ सॉल्ट एंड लीव इट फॉर अराउंड 5 to 7 मिनट्स। Just we need very few ingredients for this. We need whole of like lots of garlic. I've taken 10 to 15 cloves of garlic, half onion, 1 tomato, coriander leaves and 2 to 3 green chilies. We need red chili powder, all these basic masalas, salt, turmeric powder or haldi, coriander powder. This is anardana powder, dry mango powder, sorry. This is pomegranate seed powder and this is amchur, dry mango powder and oil. That's all. These are the only few ingredients we need for this. So now what I've done is I have already put the salt on these brinjals. I'm going to squeeze out some water. It's been 5 minutes already now. I've switched on this flame. We have to take this white pan, any white pan you have, because we need to put these brinjals on and put around 2 to 3 big spoons of oil. And I've squeezed out the water now. You can see, and there are this crisscrosses. I'm going to place these brinjals like this on the skin, on the bottom. Just 3 will be enough now in this pan, and we have to roast it very, very on very slow flame, and then we will turn on the sides. It's going to take few minutes, but make sure that the flame is quite low. While these brinjals are roasting, I am going to prepare masala for this to stuff inside. I have put already these garlic cloves and green chili and small piece of ginger. And now I am going to blend it. First, only these 3 together. Done this on for 1 to 2 times now. This is not finely, this is roughly chopped. Next I am going to add onions. There's half onion to it. And again, let's blend it. These coriander leaves now, after chopping onions. Now I am going to add these tomatoes. Only 1 tomato I have chopped into pieces. And now I am going to add these dry masalas, red chili powder. Stuffed bangan is like meant to eat very spicy. It tastes very nice with the spices. Doesn't taste very nice when you make it a little mild. Now I'm going to add this coriander powder. 2 full teaspoons. Anardana powder. Almost 3/4 spoon. And little bit of amchur powder. I'm going to blend this. We don't have to make a paste, we have to just make a masala, coarse masala. Yeah, I'm going to turn these brinjals now. See, it has been cooked on this side, it has become soft. Just turn them on the other side and keep the flame low. Be very careful, the oil is very, this pan is very hot. Like this, and same we'll just leave for another few minutes in the slow flame. Masala is also ready. I'm going to transfer to this bowl. It's coarse, the masala is really coarse and nice. I'll show you. See how it is. We'll add the salt now, because otherwise it would just leave the water and it won't be good. They have become soft now. They are half almost cooked. See on the other side also. I'm going to take them out on the plate. Very nice. Become soft quickly. Switch off the flame and then we'll fill the masala. This masala which we have grinded. This is ready now. I'm going to add salt to it. Because brinjals also I had put some salt, so be careful with the salt. Just put according to your taste. Now mix it quickly. See, this is coarse. Tomatoes and coriander are supposed to be added at the last. Otherwise, it will be very, very watery and won't stick to the brinjals. Now this is ready to fill inside the brinjals. I'm taking this. Just hold the brinjals and just try to press in the masala in these cuts, which I put crisscrosses. Let's try to put it properly so that it goes inside. Just try to press it a little like this. Like this, I'm going to fill with all these brinjals. These brinjals, very nicely, they look so good, very colorful, and the smell also very nice. I'm going to place these again. Put some oil, little bit of more oil. I'm going to place these again like this with the masala, like this. Just be very careful, do it with very light hands so the masala doesn't come out. Just turn them on this side. First, put the flame high for medium high for 2 minutes, and then on the slow flame, and then we are going to turn on the other side. It's been few minutes now. Let's see how it is cooked on the other side with masala. Wow, see, look, the masala is properly stuck to it, this brinjal, and this has become soft also. I'll show you. It looks like it's almost done. I'm also going to turn these also, brinjals. Be very careful because these are quite soft. So, yeah. Look at them, wow. The special garlic masala, and these look amazing, and they are also very nice. Especially in winters, you will enjoy a lot these brinjals. Gonna put the masala back here properly on both sides, become soft and tender and very, very nice. They smell very awesome. Garlic masala is like properly cooked. Whole brinjals are, just see, they are not even broken. Masala hasn't even come out, so they are ready to serve. You can have with bajri ki roti, which is called millet flour, or maybe roti or paratha, whatever. They are very, very nice. Please do try them. I'm going to plate them now.